If you've recently purchased a new iPhone, you may have been surprised that there was no charging block in the box. This was a change Apple made in the past year, and earned them quite a bit of backlash. After all, why wouldn't they include a charging block with a $1,000 phone? Well, that's exactly what I'll explain right now. So Apple's official reason is that not including a charging brick with every iPhone is more environmentally friendly, and there is some truth to that. The material that makes up each power brick is a very durable plastic designed to keep users safe if the unit overheats, but that also means it's difficult to break down and recycle, contributing to the growing e-waste problem. Plus, not including a power brick or headphones means a smaller box, allowing Apple to fit 70% more iPhones on each shipping pallet. In total, the reduction in carbon emissions would be like removing 450,000 cars from the road every year. Also, Apple claimed that over 2 billion iPhone power bricks are already in circulation, so most users wouldn't need a new one anyway. But there's more to the story that Apple hasn't mentioned. For example, the vast majority of power blocks already in use aren't USB-C, which means the cable included with the new iPhone won't plug into an old brick, forcing users to continue using their old cable that may be worn, frayed, or unreliable. Also, there's a huge financial aspect to this decision that Apple hasn't acknowledged. The iPhone 12 models were the first to feature 5G, and including that technology wasn't cheap. Previously, the iPhone 11 Pro's most expensive component was its triple-lens camera system at about $73, but with the iPhone 12, the 5G modem became its priciest component at about $90. And this additional expense wasn't limited to the higher-priced iPhone models as was the case with a triple-lens camera. Instead, every model, including the $700 12 mini, had to account for the $90 modem. So in an effort to cut costs and retain a high profit margin, Apple stopped including a charging brick and headphones while enjoying reduced shipping costs since they could fit 70% more units on each pallet. So while it is true that these changes benefit the environment to some degree, the type of green Apple really appeared to be after was money. This is Greg with Apple Explained. Thanks for watching till the end, and I'll see you in the next video.